Hey everyone, I'm Naman and today we'll be discussing problem B1 and B2 of code forces round 659 div 2.
So the question says that there is a shore of a sea and an island which is exactly n plus 1 meters away from the shore. So let's say we had n equals to 4, then we can say that there is a distance of 5 meters between the shore and the island. And also we can say that we can place exactly n points between the shore and the island. Now we are given the depth of the sea at each of these endpoints, and we are also told about the tides that are present in the sea, which increase for the first k seconds and then decrease for the next k seconds. Now we have to move from the shore to the island, given that whenever we are at any point in the sea, the depth of the sea is always less than or equal to n. We are also given that we can wait at any point in the sea and let the tides fall or rise, making sure that the depth of that point doesn't exceed n. Now let's take an example here. Let's say the depths were 2, 2, 1 and 3 and k was 2. So now we know that the depth will increase for the next 2 seconds. Therefore, this 2 becomes 3 and then it becomes 4. Now we know the depth will decrease for the next 2 seconds. Therefore, this becomes again 3 and then it gets 2. And now the pattern follows. Therefore, this becomes 3, then 4 and then 3 again. And likewise for this 2 also, everything will be same. 3, 4, 3, 2, 3. 4 and 3. Now for this one, we know that the depth will increase for the next 2 seconds. Therefore, this 1 becomes 2 and then it becomes 3. Now the depth will decrease for the next 2 seconds. Therefore, this 3 becomes 2, 1, and now the pattern follows. Therefore, 2, 3, 2. Now for this 3, we know the depth will increase for the 2 seconds. Then this 3 becomes 4 and 5. Now we decrease this depth. Therefore, this becomes 4 and back 3. Now the pattern follows, therefore 4. Now let's try to solve this for n equals to 3. That means the depth of our position can never be more than 3. So let's say we start at t equals to 0. So we'll reach point 1 at t equals to 1 and the depth will be 3, which is less than or equal to 3. Now we cannot stay here because the depth at this point at the next second will be 4, which is greater than 3. Therefore we try to move. But when we try to move, we see that the depth is 4, which is again greater than 3. Therefore, there is no way we can reach the island with t equals to 0. Now, let's try for t equals to 2. We know that we'll reach point 1 at depth 3, which is less than or equal to 3. Therefore, we are okay. Now, let's say we move from this point to this. Now, the depth is 2, which is again less than or equal to 3, which is okay. Now, we move from this 2 to this 2. Again, the depth is less than or equal to 3. Therefore, we are okay. Now, we know that if we move at this point, we'll reach at 5, which is greater than 3. Therefore, we try to wait here. We get this 3, which is again less than or equal to 3. Now, we know if we move from this point to this, again we'll have something greater than 3. Therefore, we try to wait here again. Now, we get this 2. According to this pattern, we know we'll have 3 here. Now, we know that if we move at this point, we'll get 3 here, which is less than or equal to 3. And now, we can say that there is a way to reach from the shore to the island. Now, let's try to analyze this pattern here. So, the pattern is 2. 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 3. So let's say at t equals to 0, we are at this position. Now, since the next value is 3, which is less than or equal to 3, therefore we can say that we can also stay at this position at t equals to 1. Now, the next position has depth 4, therefore we cannot stay at this position. Now, since at t equals to 0, the depth was 2, and let's say this is t equals to minus 1, the depth was 3, therefore we can say that we might have come at this position at t equals to minus 1. Now with this we can say that the range of this 2 is from minus 1 to 1. Now let's repeat this process for this 2 also. So for this 2 everything will remain same. Now let's do this for t equals to 1, for the position 3. Now this has a pattern of 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 2. Now, since let's say at t equals to 0, we were at this one. Now, since everything after this is less than or equal to 3, therefore we can say that the range is plus infinity. And since everything before this is less than or equal to 3, therefore we can say that the range is minus infinity. Since we know that the pattern repeats itself after every 2k seconds, therefore we can say this minus infinity and plus infinity as minus k and plus k also. Now, let's do this for this 3 also. So, the pattern for 3 is 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, p equals to 0, we were at this 3. Now, everything before this is greater than or equal to 3, and everything after this is greater than or equal to 3. Therefore, we can say that the range of this 3 is from 0 to 0. Now, if you see, this range is nothing but plus minus L minus depth. And for situations like these, when L minus depth is greater than K, we can say that this is L minus depth, comma K, and minimum of these two values. Now, let's look at this example again. So, we had 2, 2, 1, 3. We now know that the range of this two is from minus 1 to plus 1. And for this also, minus 1 to plus 1. For this one, we know that the range is from minus 3K to plus K, which is actually minus 2 to plus 2. And for this 3, we have the range from 0 to 0. Now, we can say that the earliest we can start is at t equals to minus 1. Therefore, the earliest we can reach at the next position would be minus 1 plus 1. That means t equals to 0. Therefore, we can edit this lower limit from minus 1 to 0. And likewise, we can say that the earliest we can reach at this one will be 0 plus 1. That is t equals to plus 1. But we don't have to edit the lower limit of this one, because we know that this plus 2 is actually plus infinity, and this 1 can achieve all its states again. Therefore, the lower limit of this one remains the same. Now, we can say that the earliest we can reach at this 3 will be minus 2 plus 1, that is minus 1. And since 0 is already greater than minus 1, therefore we can say that we have an answer for this. So, let's try to apply the same approach for a different example. So, let's say the depths were 1, 2, 3, 2 and 2. Now, let's write the full ranges first. So, we know that the range will be plus minus L minus depth. Therefore, for this one, we know that the range will be from 3 minus 1, that is minus 2 to plus 2. And likewise, for this 2, it will be 3 minus 2, that means minus 1 to plus 1. For this 3, it will be 0 to 0. Here, minus 1 to plus 1. And again, minus 1 to plus 1. Let's edit the ranges now. We know that the earliest we'll reach this 1 is minus 2. Therefore, we can say that the earliest we'll reach this 2 is at minus 2 plus 1, that is minus 1. Since this is already minus 1, we don't have to change anything. Now, the earliest we can reach at this 3 will be minus 1 plus 1. That means 0. This is already 0. Now, we can say that the earliest we'll reach at this 2 will be 0 plus 1, that is plus 1. Therefore, we can change this minus 1 to plus 1. Now, since we know that the earliest we'll reach at this 2 is plus 1, therefore, we can say that the earliest we'll reach at this 2 will be plus 2. Therefore, we can change this minus 1 to plus 1, plus 2. And now, if we see that the lower limit of this 2 is greater than the upper limit of this 2, therefore, we can say that there is no way of reaching.
So this is the code. I'll have the link of the submission in the description below so that you can have a look at it. That's it for this video. Feel free to contact me in Code Forces if you still have any doubts. Do subscribe to the channel if you like the video.